The police say significant resources were dedicated to investigate Raisa Khan's false claims that they had mishandled a sexual assault case. They were responding to Leader of the Opposition Pritam Singh's comments at the Committee of Privileges hearing, where he questioned the amount of work the police had put into looking into the allegations by former Workers' Party MP. The police say they went through many records, including all those of visitors to all police stations island-wide since 2017. And this was to try and identify Ms. Khan's alleged visit she mentioned in Parliament this August. Now, two rounds of checks were conducted to ensure a thorough investigation. Officers also combed through more than 1,400 sexual assault cases and related cases from 2018 to this year. The police add that they also checked through all sexual assault feedback received from members of the public in 2018, but could not link any to the case Ms. Khan had mentioned. Now, the force says the impact of such falsehoods is not just in terms of man hours lost. It also caused a delay in handling other matters and cases.
Three special reports, hours of video recordings, and more expected to come as the Committee of Privileges keeps up a probe into Ms. Khan's conduct. She had lied twice over 3 months in Parliament about how the police mishandled a sexual assault case.
Now, one political observer says making the testimonies public allows people to understand why the party leadership acted the way it did. And this includes the revelation that Ms. Khan had already confessed to Workers' Party leaders as early as August. Leaders of the opposition and WP chief Pritam Singh said during his hearing that it wasn't important for such information to be made public.
What stands out is the party's leadership, seeming lack of concern, with the fact that a lie had been made in Parliament, that the lie had been perpetuated. And from the evidence, it seemed as though the party leadership didn't seem to feel that there was any concerted attempt, to urgently, clarify the truth, for Ms. Khan, to make a position clear, so that she would not be breaching the privileges of Parliament or of being an MP. So I think the evidence before the Committee of Privileges does suggest that the Workers' Party has a mountain to climb in terms of winning public opinion. That not only did it did what it could, but that it also did the right thing, at every step of the way.
So I certainly didn't feel it was relevant for the purposes of understanding what had to be done to Ms. Khan.
But by 2nd December, it became relevant because people were asking questions about...
Because there was a press conference I was going to hold, and I know that the question would come up. So
it's completely circuitous, Mr. Singh.
It's not, Mr. If you try to look at my thinking, realize it's not circuitous.
I asked you, why is it relevant? You said it's a press conference. Why do you say it in a press conference? Because it is now relevant. Circuitous.
I mean, for the purposes of forming an argument, theoretically, I can see what you're saying, but I'm sure you understand the substance of where I'm going with a press conference.
The fact that this information was not laid out to the public, I think that gives rise to some concern. It leads one to wonder whether the party leadership was attempting, to shape public opinion through the selective release of information that they felt were relevant or important, that they decide, that rather than letting the public decide what was relevant or important, the party felt that it was to their advantage, to make those judgment calls.
The party's vice chair, Faisal Manab, also told the committee that even when leaders knew of the lie, they did not discuss how to address it. That's even when he felt it was not right to leave it uncorrected and could have been an offence. Mr. Faisal says he left it to Mr. Singh to deal with the matter, as he was a seasoned politician.
And your own duty as a member of parliament, never mind that you're a senior member of the Workers' Party, any member of parliament, has a duty to ensure that no untruth remains on the record, right?
That's what we want to do.
You have to do, right?
Yes, correct.
And so, when you knew that an untruth not only remained on the record for 8 weeks,
yes,
but was repeated on the 4th of October several times,
yes,
why didn't you do something about it?
Because I know that the truth will come out. Just that Pritam has to make a judgment, which I don't know what's stopping him, because I wasn't privy to what he has at that point in time.
It suddenly suggested that within the party, there was the trust and confidence that Mr. Pritam Singh, as the party leader, would do the right thing, with regard to how Ms. Khan's lies ought to be dealt with vis-a-vis Parliament. It also conveyed a picture of perhaps neglect, that nothing seemed to be moving, given that lying to Parliament is, a serious misconduct on the part of any member of Parliament.